Ready? You ready to fight?
All right, so two truly elite strikers here. We sat down with them on Thursday and asked them their thoughts of taking this fight to the ground. They want to strike.
They want to strike. That's what got them to the show. That is the path.
Oh! Huge right hand! Oh! He's out!
He got him!
Oh, my goodness. What a fight.
Yes, sir. It goes into the...
Yo.
Love you,
babe.
Love you too.
Blah. Love you too. Hold on, I'll be back.
Direction that is forward. He knows one style that is aggressive.
Oh! Wow!
Big knee. Oh, he might be out.
Okay, good fight.
All right, do you think?
Make noise like few MMA fans around. Maybe it's something in the weather. They're escaping the snow to go inside the Bell Center. And once they're there, they're doing all those other things, John. They're drinking the beer. They're taking in the great fights. And they are cheering as loud as they can. They want to be heard. They make themselves a part of the competition. And the fighters love it.
30 seconds now to go in the fight. Wow!
Dude hurts. Serve him up. Go get him.
That nigga mad. Nigga, that nigga quit. That nigga quit.
This fight actually goes to the ground.
This fight does not go to the ground. This one will be fought in the pocket. Two guys will stand in front of each other and will trade punches. they will trade kicks. It's going to be a classic matchup that you normally see inside of a ring. You get it in the octagon.
Oh, really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC. And he landed the right hand there. Man, he's timed his shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed a target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop him. John, stop him. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Oh, tags him. Oh!
Now he's on top of him looking for the kick.
Oh, and that is him. Referee has seen nothing. Maybe so have we. Your winner by TKO.
That was a great performance. Way to land those strikes and go and chase down the finish when you get an opportunity.
Some highlights from this one. This was a fight that had it all, and for my money, his best performance to date.
His best performance to date in the biggest.
Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest.
UFC middleweight division fight. So far, nice hook lands. Oh! Oh, yeah. Well, he gets up again here, but he looks hurt. Well, he misses with the left punch there. Official decision is in it. Result.
Dang.
Next, we get to this UFC middleweight division fight. well. The tension is palpable as this fight gets underway, and going to be interesting to see how this matchup plays out. Definite striker on one side against another guy.
And in those situations, normally the guy that's more well-rounded will be the one that will find success. I want to see how this plays out.
All right, so there it is, the early takedown. He told everyone here during fight week within earshot that he was going to try to wrestle, try to get this fight to the ground, and had no problem doing so just there.
During their fight camp, they made a checklist. They checked off the most important part of the fight, getting an early takedown.
Oh, nice land there with the punch. You see, he's taking advantage of what is an obvious edge and reach.
He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
That punch will work right through the guard. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Oh, bleeding from his cheek now. Damage done.
Now he's on top of him looking for a finish. This is a really, really close fight.
All right, look.
We came a long way.
Yeah, let's go.
I just got the check, I spent it all up on my shoes. If you do not pay me, I'll have to cut you loose. They said that I'm gonna make it in my touch sensation. Made a lot of money, think it's time for a vacation. Every day I wake up thinking, God damn, I just made it. I don't fuck with fake, so I just put them in the basement. Ladies really.
What's up, YouTube? What's good, y'all? I make sure y'all subscribe to my YouTube channel, man. Y'all already know. Yeah, that's easy.
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC middleweight division fight.
Fergie, Fergie finna lay him down. Sippin' on Hennessy, hoppin' up Bentley, in the mile.
Who am I?
Trap, no.
Ay,
look at me now.
Trap,
no. Look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me now.
Trap,
no.
Yeah.
Look at me now.
Trap,
no.
Look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me now.
Coming up next, our main event, a matchup for the UFC middleweight division title.
Ready? You ready to fight?
Yeah. All right, let's get this one started here. Round one is underway, and we've got a striker who is the first to be reckoned with. Tonight, though, he draws an eye with a little bit of
him. And that guy is usually the one that will have the advantage. But we know what a high-level striker is, and this guy is as high-level as we've ever seen in the UFC.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the defense.
Well, defense doesn't necessarily win championships in MMA, but he's doing a nice job blocking these shots.
He's not allowing his opponent to get any damage off of him by blocking all these attacks. Ooh, head kick lands. He's hurt.
Romero gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there. Parts of the strike lands, but my children hit hard.
Yeah, at this point, early in the fight, you saw his head snap back. You can see the effect the punch was taking. Now, he may as well just smack him on the arm like, good job, guy. What a fight.
Now, he's masterful from here.
Oh, he went to a single, switched to a high crotch.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Well, you see all the grappling repetitions here. Just beautiful movement, seamless transitions on them.
Over and over, these guys are doing things that you see in every jiu-jitsu gym around the country.
All right, working out of side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you got to be careful here. All right, well, he continues to manhandle him here on the ground. Now maybe trying to get to a choke position here, DC. Just over 3 minutes to go in our first round. Romero's right back to the full mount here. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Well, you gotta stay busy on the bottom. He's doing it here. Nice punch. Got the single collar tie. Oh, now gets an underhook to get a more dominant position.
Right hand punch from the clinch.
Hip tosses him down. Now we'll see if he can advance position.
I mean, right into side control.
Back to the stand-up now. Both fighters upright.
I mean, he's cutting down the size with these beautiful leg kicks. That right hand hurt him a little bit.
All right, so a nice shot there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave. Whether it's
the Olympic silver medalist Romero gets another takedown. The question now, what will he do with it? Well, no surprise, he goes for the takedown there, unable to get the fight to the canvas.
This is a testament to his opponent, his ability to see the shots coming, defend them, and make the fight happen where he wants to.
The soldier of God gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up.
Over and over. You come up, you go down. Another takedown land. Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish. Oh, watch Gucci
again.
Here.
Working on a choke. Nicely done.
Go,
goes upstairs for an elbow. Oh, nice. All right, so now we are on the ground. Now he is in his wheelhouse. We'll see if he can get one of his submissions to pop here tonight. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Oh, the ground and pound strikes continue to rain down. The opponent better move out of harm's way or the referee's going
to
stop this.
He better start to move. And when his opponent starts to posture, he needs to put his feet on the hip, push him away to try to escape this very, very dangerous position.
Oh, trying to pass here, but Dikembe Mutombo style, he gets denied.
Blocked. Great job blocking that pass by the bottom fighter.
Back to his feet. Romero gets caught by that straight punch. That'll get his attention. Oh, continuing to attack the head as that diving punch lands. Pretty good work with the strikes here off of his back by Romero. Horn sounds for the end of round one. All right, well, we'll see if his opponent can make the requisite adjustments. He got taken down left and right there that previous round.
It's going to be very difficult because he never got a specific type of takedown. It was always something different, but it always led to his opponent getting great top positions. Ooh, what a punch.
Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
Doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes.
Whiffs on the right hand. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. Well, good news, bad news, right? The strike there lands, but just not much steam on it because his gas tank seems to be on the verge of empty.
The gas tank is completely empty. All that butt mashing did you no good. You wasted your energy. You wasted your time. Now it's just a matter of when your opponent decides to finish it.
Effective punch there by Romero. Well, he's doing a nice job keeping the guard up, but that usually means the body is wide open. His opponent wisely saw that and landed the straight hand to the body. Let's see if he shores some things up here defensively to prevent it.
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, he might be out. Oh, straight right.
Again, back into this position.
Just doing a nice job not telegraphing his shot. Clean entries. The Olympian's got to like what he sees.
I mean, over and over, he gets to the legs before his opponent reacts. By beating him on the entry, now it's up to the opponent to keep up. But this guy's playing chess. His opponent's playing checkers. He's playing chess. He can't keep up once he gets to his legs. He's got to beat him defensively before he gets his hands locked around his legs or his body. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back in range.
Here, DC, this could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you got to be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need to control posture on the bottom. And if you're the top guy, the guy that's pulled.
Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. He's doing a great job of mixing everything up.
Pinpoint accuracy on that kick.
No windup, no tell, just a brutal kick.
Well, a really good second round for him thus far. After a somewhat lackluster first round, he has found the rhythm and found his striking range. Scary proposition for the opponent now here in round two. 83 total strikes and counting have already found the mark for Yoel Romero. He's up!
You ready to fight? Ready.
Well, the tension is palpable as this fight gets underway, and going to be interesting to see how this matchup plays out. Definite striker on one side against the other guy who can really beat him.
And in those situations, normally the guy that's more well-rounded will be the one that will find success. I want to see how this plays out.
Nice job by the fighter here to continue to block the shots coming his way. You think he's trying to... All right, so there it is, the early takedown. He told everyone here during fight week within earshot that he was going to try to wrestle, try to get this fight to the ground, and had no problem doing so just there.
During their fight camp, they made a checklist, and they checked off the most important part of the fight, getting an early takedown. Oh!
Oh, he's got that right hand going tonight, DC, connected with it there.
He's thrown so many left jabs. Throw that right punch straight down the pipe. It's unreal. He's got to be careful dipping his head when he's throwing that jab. If your opponent has you in the clinch, pulling down on your head, landing punch after punch, you have got to clear that collar tie, reach back inside, and try to find space.
Well, he continues to find the openings tonight. Beautiful connection with the punch there.
Accuracy at its best.
Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Our bottom fighter here maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Gets up again here, but hurting. Romero's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. Wow, that right punch has been the money weapon for him tonight, and he landed it again there. Hey, finally gets the takedown. It wasn't for any lack of effort, but finally that shot was good enough to get his opponent down.
I don't know how many times, John, I could have watched this guy shoot takedown attempts without securing one. It's almost like out of pity. You feel good for him to finally get it done. Now what does he do with this top control?
Oh, wow, that happened quickly as the fighter reverses position there on the ground.
Unbelievable position change. Wow, what a transition.
He's the biggest shot in the fight thus far. How's his opponent still standing?
I mean, I have no idea. This fight is supposed to be over. It might not be over now, but it's going to be over very soon. Now he's on top of him looking for the finish.
And that'll do it.
He got him.
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught that ultimately appeared as though the outcome was an eventuality. So if you're the referee, you got to protect the fighter, and I thought he did a good job of doing just that. Now let's get you some replays now. Certainly a lot for our replay guys to work with in the truck. This was a clinic tonight in terms of mixed martial arts acumen in every realm of the game.
A full-on display of all of his skills. He did everything in his championship-winning performance. He used his wrestling. He used his elbows. He used his pace and pressure to really wear down his opponent so that he can get his hand raised.
All right, let's go inside the octagon where Bruce Buffer has the official decision. Welterweight division title.
Ready.
All right, so we've got two classically trained strikers here. Any chance this fight actually goes to the ground?
This fight does not go to the ground. This one goes watch in the pocket. Two guys will stand in front of each other. They will trade punches. They will trade kicks. It's going to be a classic matchup that you normally see inside of a...
All right, so here we go with round one, classic matchup of striker versus striker. These guys have both faced a lot of grapplers in the past. They like to draw time.
Oh, yeah, they love seeing an opponent that will not be trying to dive at their legs. They know when they get to the center of the octagon, the only steps back they will take is if they choose to move out of range to re-enter back into the striking realm. It's a very comforting thought for both of these competitors.
Oh, lands a stiff punch there. Nice connection.
Oh, nice land.
Rock him, sock him out of the chute here. Oh, heavy leg kick. Oh, straight right. Oh. Trying to hammer that lead leg. Oh, beautiful jab by him there. Got that to the target quickly.
He's dictating the fight with a jab.
All right, so he lands another jab now, just snapping that thing off, DC.
I believe that the jab was lost in mixed martial arts initially, but now it has been found, and it's been found by this young man in this octagon tonight.
Nice strike to the midsection, glances.
Oh! Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, Johnson. He's got to press him. He's got to chase that finish down now. Oh, no!
Big hook. Looking to land the right hand, he misses. Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Don't finish this fight.
Oh, he might be out.
Start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, that's a big hook there. Wow, huge head kick. All right, so there he goes, continuing to land that jab. When they put this highlight together, it's just going to be one head snapping back.
It's going to be boxers going back and watching this guy and going, wow, this is what a jab is supposed to look like. Big punch lands over the top. How's he going to follow this one?
Able to check that kick as well. Straight right, he misses. Well, the strike lands there, but doesn't do a ton of damage because the fighter's cooked.
Yeah, he's done. He's thrown everything with it with absolute power. And now it does not matter how many times you jam on that X button, it will not do any damage.
Looking to land the right just out of range.
Nice punch.
Strike there. He could be in trouble.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad. He doesn't know if he's in the octagon or at his mama's house for Thanksgiving. Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him. Knock him out. The fight's done.
Oh, nice job to block the kick. Well, he has really put his opponent on the defensive here early. Very aggressive right out of the chute. He has landed a high number of total strikes. Exactly the aggression you'd like to see, given what is at stake here tonight.
Look at him chopping the wood.
That one appeared to stun him.
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him. He's getting lit up right now.
Oh, huge right hand. Oh, straight right.
Look at the angle of that nice body kick. Nice looping punch.
One more of those, he might be out.
I mean, the fight is going to be over. I can't believe he's still standing. That shot made it perfect.
punch coming is blocked. Hurt here. You can even see him limping a little bit. Over the top. This fight's going to be over.
What a great way of running up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high when his opponent thought he was going low, and now he's got him hurt very badly.
It's okay. He just got caught. Need this round to be... All right, let's check out some of the action.
Ready, fight. Ready. Good.
Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back in range.
All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block a shot that's incoming. Chase that finish down now.
Weapon for him tonight, and he landed it again there.
If his opponent does not change something, he will continue to throw the strike until he makes it stop the
win. And both fighters exchange in the pocket. And he connects there with a punch, so pretty good striking display by him thus far.
He does.
Kick home, and now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize it. It was coming high, and now he's got him hurt bad.
Looking to set up a knee of his own. Oh! All right, single collar tie now. And now he goes with a combination of punches to the head. Potentially some concussive damage there.
I mean, absolutely concussive damage. Landing all those strikes to the head. He's very accurate, he's very fast, and he has a real confidence every time he throws his punches. I mean, look at the commitment to kicking in this fight.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
Man. What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds.
Big body kick land.
Big left hook coming, gets blocked.
Great punch. What a body kick.
Oh! And just like that, the fight is over.
Sleeping, so the beef and things not needed, but I had big man turn Jesus.